You're listening to Financial Advisor Marketing, the best show on the planet for financial advisors who want to get more clients without all the stress. You're about to get the real scoop on everything from lead generation to closing the deal. James is the founder of theadvisorcoach.com, where you can find an entire suite of products designed to help financial advisors grow their businesses more rapidly than ever before. Now, here is your host, James Pollard.
Welcome to Financial Advisor Marketing. It's the best podcast, in my biased opinion, on this planet for financial advisors. And I'm glad you're here, glad you're with us. And I want to start off this show by saying thank you to an Inner Circle member who recently sent me an email. And I don't know if he'd want me to share his name on the podcast, so I'm not going to. But essentially, he says, and I have it right here, he says, thank you for everything you put into these monthly newsletters. At first, I thought I didn't have much to learn after 13 years in the business. You have definitely proved me wrong. Every month, I learn something new and implement the advice to see stellar results. Ooh, stellar. That's a nice, good word there. I'm even keeping a little notebook with ideas I get that I can put to use later on in my career. Keep up the good work. So pretty nice email there. Made my day. So thank you. I appreciate you. And guys, keep them coming.
Just
keep,
13 years, eh?
Yeah, keep sending me these things. And if you want to get my monthly paper and ink Inner Circle newsletter, make sure you visit theadvisorcoach.com/newsletter and sign up today. It will rock your world. And you can cancel at any time. There are no refunds, no money back guarantee. So if you lose sleep over that and it makes your stomach churn or you quake in your boots, it is not for you. I don't want anyone to, you know, inherit financial trouble just to join the Inner Circle. But you know, if you're a financial advisor and you've got $99 to spare, and if you don't, cancel your cable or whatever you're spending your money on that's not paying you, invest in the Inner Circle and see if it's for you. It probably is. So in my biased opinion, once again, biased opinion here. So let's get into the good stuff. This episode is all about why busy is the new stupid. And my inspiration for this podcast is actually a mix of a few things, and it's primarily from my work with financial advisors and helping them improve their productivity. And it's a fairly new area for me. You know, I released the Peak Productivity product back in October 2018, and it has done extremely well. And it's revealed to me that financial advisors are really concerned about being productive, and not just in terms of making more money, like raw production and insurance and money management, but I mean like actual productivity, like getting more stuff done in less time. And if you think about it, improving your productivity is some of the best stuff you can do, because if you make $40 an hour and you get an extra 10 hours of productive time each week, that's like $400 back in your pocket, or $400 more income for you. And you do the math based on your own income and how much money you make and the amount, how much time you save. So do the math for you. If you make $100 an hour, it's $1,000 a week back in your pocket or that you save. And my other inspiration for this is I was doing some reading about German World War II General Erich von Manstein. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. Probably not. I just read this. It's not like I watched a movie or anything. And he categorized his officers into four types. And as I go through this, you'll realize this guy was a pretty smart cookie. And I'm going to start categorizing people into these categories, Jonathan.
I'm bad.
The type one, the very first category that he would categorize people into, is lazy and stupid.
Well, there's most people.
Most people are category one, type one, lazy and stupid. But our buddy here, Eric, the general, he actually left these people alone. They didn't do any harm. They were just sheeping along, I should say, being the sheep that they are, just hanging out. You know, I'm sure if he asked them directly to do something and put a little force behind it, I'm sure they would do it. But for the most part, they didn't harm anybody. They're just lazy and stupid. And in today's world, it's just people who come home, you know, sit on the couch, watch Netflix for 4 hours or so, and then go to bed. Most people. There's a reason why the online education platforms like Lynda from LinkedIn is making a smaller amount of money than the behemoth Netflix. And it's kind of like if you ask people what their favorite book is, they'll say the Bible, but they don't really read it. And if you ask people if they're interested in education and improving themselves, they'll say yes. But when you check their Netflix account, they're much more interested in entertainment. So if you think that most people are interested in educating themselves and improving themselves, you would be sadly mistaken. And I would be a lot more impactful and a lot more influential if more people were interested in this kind of stuff, Jonathan. But if you're one of the people who invest in yourself, hey, you're one of the rare ones. Kudos to you. Type two, category two is hardworking and clever. So he said that these people made good officers because they ensured that everything ran smoothly. They work hard, they bust their hump, break their back, whatever you want to say. They made sure stuff got done, Jonathan. Hardworking and clever. And they were smart enough to realize that there are certain needs and certain wants, you know, and things had to get done. And maybe they found a way to get things done easier and faster than other people. I don't know. But so far, those are the two types that we have. Type number one, lazy and stupid. Type number two, hardworking and clever. And then type number three is the hardworking idiot. And he said you had to get rid of these people as quickly as possible because they perform pointless tasks. And this is just like being busy today, that you could be busy doing the wrong things. So if you're a financial advisor out there and you're listening to me right now, perhaps you're really busy on all the administrative tasks, like filling out paperwork and doing all this stuff that you could easily outsource to someone else. You could get an assistant, you could get a receptionist, you could hire someone and get that off of your plate as soon as possible. If you're just caught up in all this stuff and you can't market and you can't prospect and you can't grow your business, you might be a hardworking idiot. And according to this World War II general, you should be dealt with promptly and swiftly. You get rid of you as soon as possible.
Hey, financial advisors. Are you ready to take your business to the next level and get more clients with less stress? I invite you to join the James Pollard Inner Circle, a paper and ink newsletter that gets delivered directly to your door every month. When you join now, you'll also get a 90-minute instant download called 5 Keys to Success for Financial Advisors, a $97 value for absolutely free. All you have to do is head over to theadvisorcoach.com/newsletter and join today.
Just to refresh, we've got lazy and stupid, most people. We've got hardworking and clever. These people make good officers. Then we got hardworking idiots, and you got to get rid of these people. But the fourth category and the best category is actually lazy and clever. Now, that's me. Like, my ears perk up. That's me. I'm lazy and I'm clever, I think. So he said that these were the best people to have. And he said you should make these people generals, because lazy people are always looking for easier and simpler ways to do things. And the reason he liked this group of people so much is because he found out that lazy and clever people, they wouldn't do the unnecessary task. They were too lazy. So you have the hardworking idiots who have all these tasks in front of them, and they may be pointless, and they may not add to the bottom line, and they may not add any real value, and they would still do them because they're so hardworking and they want to get all the stuff done and they want to impress their master or whatever it is. But the lazy and clever people wouldn't do it. They would only do the essential task. And I would argue that's how we should all operate. If it's essential, you know, do it. If it's not essential, delegate it or eliminate it. Pretty simple philosophy there, Jonathan.
Yeah.
So if you're lazy and clever, wave your hands in the air like you just don't care. And not to get sidetracked, I was going
to get somebody to raise them for you.
Yeah. Yeah. Wait. Let me tell this story. I was going to write an email about this, but I decided not to. So I just tell it on the podcast. When I was in high school, I had this business teacher named Mr. Shelton, and he was a bit of a hard ass. There's no other word really to describe it. And he just one of those teachers is loud and boisterous and try to pump the students up. And that works for some people. It doesn't really work for me. And he was like, I can't remember exactly what it was. I guess like people weren't doing their work or something. He was like, all right, guys. He's like, you want to be so lazy? He's like, you're lazy. You're never going to get anywhere. He's like, if you want to succeed, you got to work hard. You're not going to be lazy. He's like, all right, you guys are so proud of being lazy. Everyone who is lazy, raise your hand right now. And everyone in the class except me raised their hand. And he like, and I didn't really like Mr. Shelton. He was okay, but yeah, sometimes he just got on my nerves. So he pointed me out and he said, see, you should all be like Mr. Pollard here. He's like hardworking. He's not lazy. And I, I responded, Mr. Shelton, I was just too lazy to raise my hand. And he freaked.
I bet.
He got so mad. And everybody was like just clowning him and laughing. So, hey, Mr. Shelton, on the long shot that you're listening to this, I do appreciate you, but man, sometimes you're just a little too much to bear. And Bill Gates, the billionaire Microsoft guy, he even said, I will always choose a lazy person to do a difficult job because the lazy person will find an easy way to do it. And that's pretty much the key to productivity. I just let the cat out of the bag, gave the whole secret away, you know, gave the farm away here, Jonathan. You kind of want to think, what would a lazy person do? You might want to make a bracelet for this or the little wristband, you know, WWALPD. What would a lazy person do? Want people to think about that. And speaking of Bill Gates, there was an interview that Bill Gates and Warren Buffett did together. And they did it with Charlie Rose. And if you want to YouTube it, you can. You can just YouTube Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, Charlie Rose interview. It's going to come up. And in that interview, Warren Buffett pulled out his calendar. And there were like 3 or 4 entries in the entire month. And so you've got Warren Buffett, one of the richest people in the world, pulling out his calendar. It's got nothing on it. But you got broke people, the hardworking idiots, as the general would call them, the calendar's full. They've got nonstop task after task after task after task. So, you know, I kind of paid attention. If one of the world's richest people has nothing on his calendar, I kind of want to figure out why. And I asked myself, why would Buffett do this? And it's because he controls his time. He doesn't manage his time. It's not like time management. He's not managing something. He controls it. And there's a difference between managing and controlling your time. And you control your time too, which means it's up to you to decide which tasks are more important than others. You know, for Buffett, it's sitting and thinking. It's reading different stock market reports and prospectuses and things like that. But for you, it's probably prospecting, marketing, and setting appointments, having appointments, and that's it. Like, that's what you need to be doing. That's your business building activity. You know, so your calendar is going to be pretty much blank except for that stuff. Then, you know, of course, meeting with your clients and following up with them and things like that. But you want to focus on the main thing. Keep the main thing, main thing. And I know it's counterintuitive here, but you can become much more productive by doing a lot less as long as you do the right things. So going back to our example, you want to be lazy and clever. So the clever part is figuring out what the right stuff is for you and doing that. That's the lazy part. The lazy part is not doing anything else except that. And so many advisors are running around like a chicken without a head. And you cut a chicken's head off, it just still runs around. They never really step back to see the big picture where most of the big money is made. And that's something I've been meditating on for like the past month. In the big picture is where the big money is made. And I think about that and I kind of relax and it makes me feel a little better that I'm not running around like a chicken with my head cut off in my own personal life because I'm focusing on the big picture. And if you want to work smarter, not just harder, make sure you clear your calendar. Go get peak productivity from my website, theadvisorcoach.com. And you're not going to double your productivity overnight or anything like that, but you will increase your productivity enough to have that video training pay for itself. And on the sales page, the big claim that I make, it's not really a big claim, it's just, yeah, a small claim actually, is that you should get at least an extra 10 hours per week in productive time. And it comes with a 365-day money-back guarantee anyway. So if you're not willing to invest a little bit of money to get 10 hours per week, it's just stupid, plain and simple. And you should go back to being one of those hardworking idiots that the general was talking about. And I will be happy to see you go. That's pretty much all I have for this episode. Talk a little bit about World War II generals and Bill Gates and Warren Buffett. This was a great episode, Jonathan.
No kidding. So what do you have coming up for us next time, James?
Next week, we're going to talk about 10 marketing mistakes I personally made. These are mistakes that I made myself. I'm not just talking about financial advisors.
You make mistakes? Come on. Hmm? You make mistakes, James? Nobody believes that.
I do make mistakes. I'm still making mistakes. I've made mistakes today. And in this episode, I'm basically going to pull back the curtain and I'm going to let everyone learn from my own mistakes.
All right. Looking forward to that. Another Financial Advisor Marketing is in the can. We'll be back in your earbuds next time. Thanks for tuning in.
This is the podcastfactory.com.